Okay, and we move on to Linux headers. So we'll start by cleaning the directory up and then running these other commands to install them. And that's complete. And move on to glibc. So once again, same with GCC, there's no separate optional packages to add on here, everything's self-contained in this version. So create temporary build and configure. And build it. And according to my notes, this takes approximately 12 minutes by the looks of it. Right, so yeah, that's taken 12 minutes. I'm going to run the tests. There's some more information in this link here that takes us to chapter 6 on running the tests. It suggests a command for capturing all of the output, including the errors, and how to view the log to find any errors that have occurred. So I'm going to run that. Again, I'm not sure how long this will take, but looking at the time it takes for chapter 6, it's 14 minutes for that. So we'll see how long it does actually take and come back in quarter of an hour or so. Okay, so that's finished. That's 13 and a half minutes. Now, the fact that there's an error is not a problem. It just indicates there were errors during the test. So let's run this command here now to view those errors. And yeah, these are the same errors that I had when I was testing. Although they're different and they're not actually mentioned here, it's not anything to particularly worry about because we are in the tools stage of the build. But the fact that they're the same, that's the only one that got mentioned actually. The fact that they're the same as what I did get when I was testing this, gives me confidence to carry on. That doesn't look bad to me at all. So it's just this bug at exit 3 in DLFCN. That one's known about and always errors. And then these two in NPTL, which are test cancel 1 and test cancel 4. So that's fine. So I think what I'll do is just close this tab down because I don't want to be following those instructions and carry on with the installation. And previously in LFS5, we did actually install the locales in this section of the build. But as it says there, there's no need to do that really. But it does say if you want to do it, to go to the section we're just in chapter 6. Okay, that's installed. I'll tidy that up. And move on to adjusting the tool chain. So I've just got to move some files around here. And change this specs file by the looks of it. And make some changes to fix includes. And then finally do a quick test to make sure the correct library is working. And you can see that we've got tools lib ldlinux.so2, which is correct. So remove them files. And that should be it for that.